In order to edit the columns of a financial report, you'll open your desired report in the Financial Report Writer and go to the Columns tab. We'll take a look at the balance sheet condensed for a basic account group structured report, just to get a quick look at what this looks like. So we can see that you can see all the columns of the report. You can see the left-hand column gives you generally a type of name or a number and a name or just a number for the account. In a dimension structure-based report, you'll see dimension there. You can get the name of the particular dimension, structure, or group. And we can also see, if we come over to this column, that we could split this out by particular dimension structure and have the column automatically split on that structure. When we go over to a dimension-based account, we'll have the option to split by account group. Within a name-based one, we get to change the name of the particular column, or we can hide the column. Within an actual, we get the option to determine how the value is calculated, whether it's from the start of the period, at the end of the period, or the duration of the period, or if we want to default back to either the default for an account group or the setting from the rows tab that we looked at earlier. We also get the option to set the reporting period for the given column. So you can see in this case, we have a current month reporting period for all three columns. And then we set an offset on each of the columns. So the current month is the current reporting period for the first column. 1 month prior to the current month is our second column. 2 months prior to the current month is our third column. We could also set that to be a future period, or we could look at many other options here, such as the current year or the current quarter, anything that you want to, and just play with your offsets. You get your preview of what the date would be, and if you need to change that, you could say, oh, I want to look at these with the value of 8/1/2023 as my date to look at. We can see what that would be if we ran this report that way. We also get to change the column heading in the actual type columns. Like I said, we can do an expansion by dimension structure or a filter by dimension structure, and we can expand by dimension. We can also determine whether we want to show that as a number or an average, or some columns give you a possibility of displaying as a percentage and that kind of thing. You can set that formatting here. And then you can set your reporting book to pay attention to for the particular column, or change some various visual indicators. Conditional highlighting is going to allow you to highlight the particular column for a row based on particular rules. So, you know, you can set it to be as greater than some value, less than, equal to, between by setting one greater, one less than, etc., and you can set a comment to describe that conditional highlighting. You can also set a color scale, which will, as it says here, do a gradient from high to low. So you would have the highest value be the color that you want or that you choose here, and the lowest value in the column would have white. You do get the option to use two colors and go from your chosen color down to white, down to your other chosen color. You can also do a sparkline, which gives you a graph over a period of time and gives you the option to expand by, depending on your selection, expand by certain amounts. If you're using any visual indicators or you're set to expand by any value, you cannot hide the column. But otherwise, you can mark a column to be hidden as well. Let's go ahead and take a look at a dimension-based report instead of an account-based report. So let's pull up the project overview report and take a look at the column structures here. Now, this report itself is significantly more complex, so we're going to take a look at a couple of additional column types, as well as the difference between the dimension and account options here. So we have the column type dropdown, instead of being a count, is based on dimensions. Otherwise, it's almost identical. You get the dimension name, the dimension ID, or the dimension ID and name. This one stays the same. Now we can see in here they've used a budget type column. This is not particularly different in this dropdown from the account. The only actual changes we'll see is the dimension and dimension attributes. Otherwise, we're pulling from the GL based on whatever dimension structure we have set up to power the rows. Now we have in this one, instead of just the standard value, we've pulled in the budget that is the original. We also see over here, we've pulled in revisions and approved. Together, these will power a summary on columns set over to the right. We can see that the reporting period is pretty much exactly the same. We have actually set a title. For the column, and that displays up there. And in this case, we've set a filter on the account group. So we're saying we want only revenue values, and then we're only getting the budget for the revenue values, and in this particular column, only the original budget. So this is all based on the setup for your budgets. We've chosen to show it as a number, but again, we could show it as an average. And if we take a look here, we've hidden the revisions in the approved budgets because these two added together are going to indicate our actual approved changes. And we're going to have that in a summary on columns. And while we're not going to talk about how to set up a summary column, I do want to go over how to read it. You can see in the summary field that there's an add set here, and then there's 3, 4. That's going to indicate that this is adding columns 3 and 4. The comma indicates explicit columns. In column 6, we're adding together the approved changes and the original contract by adding columns 2 through 4. So a colon is going to indicate a range. A comma is going to indicate specific columns. So add 2:4 means add 2, 3, and 4. Add 3, 4 means add 3 and 4. Column 6 could have referenced column 5. You can reference a calculation from another calculation. So it could have been add 2, 5 and had the exact same effect because 5 is adding 3 and 4, and 2 plus 3 plus 4 is the same as 2 plus 3 plus 4. It's important to note that calculations are done in the order that the columns are specified. So when we subtract column 7 from column 6, we say subtract 6, 7. When we want to divide the column 8 by column 6, we specify column 8 first. That's generally all we're going to cover in this particular level of editing a report. Clearly, there's more to be discussed here, but that's a great overview of how to understand the columns and generally what changes you can make to them.